So Samuel, you're coming to Spain at a very long age, young age, you know, after under 17, to move straight to Spain. How did you cope? You know, just a reflection on how you cope with that kind of lifestyle.
It was a little bit difficult for me. I mean, the first time when I came to Spain, I think my living in Spain, not understanding the language, the food, especially the food. Because you know, coming from Nigeria, it is swallow and rice and everything. When you're coming here, the meat's not well done, the eggs and everything. The rice not well cooked. So just trying to adapt, actually very well. The first year was a little bit difficult. I remember when I came with my mom, because I was minor when the first time I came here. So my mom came and they gave him one food. They gave my mom the curry, sopa de pollo. So she was a little bit, surprised. She said no, she cannot. So she was the first person that left. So she left me and go back. So I was the first time. Well, before I came back to Nigeria, then the next time I came back, it was a little bit close. Because I was staying as well, living alone, trying to come to training, because I don't have a car. You know, when you're a good player, trying using from my house to the training ground, was like 15 minutes walk. So I used to wake up, go 20 minutes, sometimes 30 minutes walk, then to study. Then I went to study to learn Spanish and everything. So every training, when I finish my training, I'll try to go to class and learn Spanish. My teacher and everything. The first one, it was a little bit difficult, so I couldn't understand me. There were so many things to write and everything. So I said, I cannot understand everything. So it was a little bit difficult for me. So from there, I went to then to normal school to try to learn. Comparing it with my training and everything, coming back late, very tired, traveling to play matches, and it was a little bit difficult. So It wasn't an easy task for me.
Talking about it wasn't an easy task for you, was there any time, you know, during your, because you're still under 17, that you feel like, I'm done, this one are too much, make I just come out, or make I go out? Have you fed up at any point in time?
Actually, no, because I didn't feel any kind of time down on me, because it was a little bit, I was actually feeling my, thinking about where I come from.
Go back to 20s.
I said, if I go back to Nigeria, I'm like, 20s. So my nigga is going to ask me, how far that guy? I come back. So I said, no, language cannot be a barrier. The food cannot be. I can never actually be drinking tea, water, or tea.
He said this, what was that?
You understand? But I said, no. Oncolos. Oncolos, everything must happen. So I was trying to fight within the first team, the under 19, 3 months. I didn't play the top team because the coach and everything, so I didn't play. I jumped to the team B. So the team B was where I did amazing job, everything, and I played the playoff. Straight to first team, then the national team, with everything that happened within a year.
Wow.
It was 1 year, everything just happened.
So you moved from the under 19 to B, you play playoff for B,
then join the first team,
and you get called up for
Super Eagles.
And
everything just happened, just straight, everything just happened. Like, before that, I told my agent, if they give me, before I signed the contract, I said, I'm going to go back to the second team. He said, Samuel, what did they give you, man? Why? I said, because I believe in myself. I know what I'm capable of doing. He said, come on, let's see. When I completed everything within a year, national team called me.
What we got to your PS4?
No waste time. you know, waste time. Yes. My PS4. They even bought another game for me. What I found, bought iPad for me. I said, yes, nice one. Now I'm mission accomplished. I said, what next? He said, I need to push forward so that I'll sign a new big contract with Villarreal as the first team
player.
I said, don't worry.
This is done.
So I started playing because I cannot sign professional contract around, so see the next year. So I said, okay, no problem. So I started playing and everything. Then I went to National School with Super Eagles.
Yeah,
so they came to see me. I was even finished. So my professional contract, you know where I signed. They were the one that built everything. So Rock Nation, Rock Nation wanted to sell the site. So they paid everything for me to go to Dubai with my family and everything.
Wow.
So I went to Dubai. He says that place I would stand my professional contract and everything.
Wow.
I said, where is that pen? That go to pen.
So you want to what? Want to demo?
So I signed two contracts at that time, Rock Nation and Larry was actually they were asking me because I have so many options if I can sign or they're happy, if I can still go, I said no, I want to stay there and meet my friend and there were so many problems. They said okay. See what will happen, see what will happen, and the contract was actually okay for me. I said, no, well, now I can, in the next few years, and I can play this and sign another new one if it's possible. But if I don't want, you know, just maintain my contract, but the more I'm signing new contracts, you know, courses and everything. So I said, no, I need to try another challenge. But that moment was a very fantastic day for me to sign, so I just signed with Rock Nation.
Away from you know the let's go and talk about you know your leisure time. You know, away from football, away from training, away from going for lectures. How do you flex? If I put it that way, how do you do your leisure? Do you just sit in your car and listen to music? Let's go and talk about that.